One of them. They call themselves a Shir en Sebenur, named after an ancient being they believe to be the world's first.
World's first what?
The world's first mutant.
As the follow-up to the previously successful X-Men universe reboots, First Class and Days of Future Past, X-Men Apocalypse is a new adventure from our 20th Century Fox heroes as they face a new big bad in Apocalypse himself. The X-Men villain Apocalypse, as we learn right away in this movie, gets his power from ancient Egyptian mythology and magic. As one of the best comic book villains out there in the Marvel, DC, or Fox movie universe, I had high hopes for Apocalypse. And overall, Apocalypse is one of the best parts, although the execution of his story arc is underutilized. By far the best parts of this film were Magneto, and the young X-Men they introduced, especially Jean Grey. Sophie Turner, one of my favorite actresses from Game of Thrones, killed it, accompanied by Quicksilver having one of his other iconic, memorable slow-motion scenes. Rounding out a team, we have young Cyclops, Nightcrawler, and even Jubilee. The strongest storyline again was with Magneto. You even got more of his origin story and him trying to assimilate into 1980s society, which was really intriguing. But the negative points of the film were definitely the stiff, unrealistic blocking at times, in the sense that the film just felt like they shot on a soundstage with a big blue screen at the actors' backs, which most likely did happen, as well as the fact that the reversals felt unearned and the plot was too easy for our X-Men heroes, and not to mention yet another 3D converted movie that doesn't really need it. I have a lot of positive outlook on where the X-Men series is going. I would say this flick is a good X-Men movie. If you like the X-Men and the comic book movies, I think you can find things to enjoy. But if you're new to the X-Men universe, this would not be the film to start with. The summer blockbuster slate is packed with action-filled comic book movies, and I feel like this one is overall worth the price of admission. But if you have to miss one, I'd miss this over Civil War or Suicide Squad.